Hello everyone, welcome back to the Synthax UK YouTube channel. My name is Matt and today I've got something a little bit different for you. Today I'm going to be showing you how to use the Icon Platform M Plus to control Adobe's Lightroom Classic. We mentioned in our overview video that whilst the Platform M Plus is a fantastic option as a DAW controller, it's capable of working with other creative programs when combined with some third-party applications. Now, to all you music tech folk who might not know what I'm talking about, Adobe's Lightroom Classic is a photography program that has tools for organizing photos as well as making non-destructive edits. Now, one of the attractions of Adobe's Lightroom is its slider-based interface, and this is something that pairs really well with the Platform M Plus because, of course, you get the 9 motorized faders. So being able to control Lightroom's slider interface with the Platform M Plus is something that is really fantastic. In music production, we often talk about how with a DAW controller, it is nice to put down the keyboard and mouse and solely focus on your DAW project. Now, the same is true with photo editing. It's nice to be able to just look at the screen, look at your edit, and really focus without distractions on what you're doing. To make this possible, what we're gonna use is a program called MIDI 2LR. And what MIDI 2LR is doing is taking the MIDI control change data of the Platform M Plus and translating it into information that Lightroom understands. So when using the Platform M Plus with Lightroom and MIDI 2LR, I can program any of the buttons on the control surface to suit my particular workflow. So you can find the download link for MIDI 2LR in the description box below. But for now, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna dive into getting it all set up and showing you the interface and how it works with the Platform M Plus. Now, first thing I'm gonna do is open the installer for MIDI 2LR. Now, I'm just gonna follow the installer and then just choose the directory where you want it saved. For the purposes of this tutorial, I want it somewhere easy to find. So I'm just going to put pictures. Now, if you've got somewhere that you particularly like to put your third-party plugins, by all means, put it in there. But as long as you can find it, that's all we're worried about. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to use the Icon IMAP software. Now, this will also be in the description box below, and I've already got it installed on my machine, so I'm just going to open it. What we're going to do here is just tweak a couple of the ways that the controls on the Platform M Plus work, just to make them work a little bit better with MIDI 2LR. Now, I'm going to turn on the Platform M Plus here, and then I'm just going to check that the fourth LED, which is user defined mode, is illuminated. I can press select, and now we are in user defined mode. Sprung in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to user defined mode in the control mode here, and then what that is now doing is effectively anything on the user defined mode, I can now change how the data is sort of transported. So one of the things that I want to remove before we start using MIDI 2LR is the touch sensitivity of the controls. So for that, I'm just going to click each of these with the cursor and just change it to null, because I'm going to use these and these will just clog up the MIDI 2LR interface. Now, the only one that you can't change is the master fader, because that's set slightly differently to interact with a DAW. So now I just need to press connect, and then my Platform M Plus version 2.15 is there. We connect to it and then we can send that data to the Platform M Plus. So now that will not recognize the touch sensitivity part of each fader, and that's something I wanted to get rid of. So for now, just to remember that, what you need to do as well is save the file. So this will save the data that you can then open again in the IMAP software, and that will remember it, because every time you close the IMAP software, it defaults back to all the controls that it had previously. Save it as Lightroom preset, and then I can recall it anytime I want in IMAP later on, should I want to edit it again. So we're done on the IMAP side. As long as we've sent the data, which I'm going to do one last time just to make sure, we can close IMAP. And now we'll go back to Lightroom and we'll install the MIDI 2LR plugin. So we go to File, Plugin Manager, and then here we're going to click Add, and then we'll go to Pictures and find the MIDI 2LR plugin, or wherever you have installed the plugin to in the installer. So we'll click Add Plugin. And there we go, it's jumped straight into life and it's opened up MIDI 2LR. MIDI 2LR will open every time now that Lightroom Classic opens. and just close the Lightroom plugin manager for now, and then we'll have a look at MIDI to LR. Now this is opened up already. As you can see, I've already got a load of commands loaded into it. What we're going to do is just remove all of them, and I'm going to show you a couple of commands in the default state of MIDI to LR. So here it is, here's MIDI to LR, completely blank as it would be when you start it up. Now, there are so many controls that you can add. I'm just going to show you quickly how it works and interfaces with Platform M+. Now, because we've made those changes in the IMAP software, as soon as I touch one fader, we just get this pitch bend control here on channel one. You get another one here on channel two, channel three, channel four, channel five, channel six, channel seven, and channel eight. Now also you've got the master fader there, but the master fader has this pitch bend control, the same as the others, but it also has this note value here. Now the note value is what's controlling that touch sensitivity. We can't get rid of it, but what we'll do is we'll just leave it unassigned to anything, because if we assign it to something, it will automatically control that. And because it's a button, it will be on or off. So essentially, if we wanted to assign it to the exposure, we'd have the exposure at max or the exposure at zero. We don't want that. So let's have a look at these pitch bends then. What we could do, let's just go to the basic tone section here on the menu, and we could add pitch bend one. I'll add the contrast, for instance. And now if we go into Lightroom, I can control the contrast with this fader. And you can see as soon as I'm finished with it, it will bounce into place there. So if I push that all the way down, just gonna think about it for a second. And there we go, it's popped itself down. We can turn it up again and it will just follow a little bit afterwards. So we can do that for all of those. And then there's some other things that we can do with the transport control, and I'm just going to load in a template that I've made already, and we'll go through some of the things that you could use the Platform M Plus for. So here is the template that I made earlier, and it's loaded up with a load of different things that we could use in Lightroom Classic. Now, so as I said earlier, I've got all of these pitch bends controlling certain values in the image. See, I'm just messing about with it. If I run across them here, we've got the exposure. As I said, I've come from this sort of music production way of thinking. The exposure is the main thing that you would want to be sort of tweaking at first with your image. So that's on my master fader here. Then 7 and 8 next to them, that's your white balance controls. So I can turn down the temperature here. And then the tint is on channel 8. Okay, I'm still ruining the image. You know, this is not how I would normally edit. And then obviously we've got the contrast, fader 1. Then we've got highlights, shadows, you can see here whites. Let's go on to Lightroom view so you can see in full action here. So whites there, blacks, and then we've got dehaze, because dehaze is a control that I use quite a lot of, so I've assigned a fader to that. And as I said, the temperature controls here too, so I can turn this down quite a lot. The control will go all the way from the bottom to the top values. So there's a long slide in that temperature control there. And then obviously the tint again here. Now there are lots of other things that I could also do here. I've got the encoders, the pushable encoders, controlling the resets for all of these values. So if I decided that I didn't like particularly how any of them worked, so I've made this change here to the highlights, let's bring them all the way down, and then I'll bring the contrast all the way up, for instance. Now I've done that, I can simply press that button and bring it back down to zero. Same with the temperature. All right, let's change the temperature here of this. And then simply press that and it will go back down to how it was originally. Now I've got the transport control here. That's controlling the motion between photos, so I can use the jog wheel here to just easily move between all of my photos. I've also got these zoom buttons. These zoom buttons add an extra layer of control to them. So obviously there's zoom, so I thought, well, if I use this left one, I can now control the zoom in and out. The right button, well, that allows me to select photos. So if I push the right zoom button, and then I can move these photos along. You can see along the bottom here, it's just selecting those photos. And then I have the jog wheel clickable button. We'll go through to the export menu. Well, what else have we got? Well, let's change some of the things on this photo here. If I just add some highlights, bring the shadows all the way down, for instance. Okay, I'm not sure on the edit I've made there at first, so let's say I can use the undo buttons here, which I've added to the transport controls, and simply undo them. I've got the play button, which is currently doing an auto tone. So if I have a photo here that's completely untouched, I just press the play button and it will give me an automatic tone adjustment. And then that kind of gives you a starting place should you need it. And of course, we've got the record buttons here. We've got the solo buttons, the mute buttons, the select buttons. All of these can be programmed in any which way that you would need in Lightroom. So you could have the develop presets along the record buttons. You could have a button that enables the profile corrections for your lenses. You know, whatever you would need from this controller that would make your workflow move much more smoothly, you can add it in here using the Platform M Plus and MIDI 2LR. Now, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I know it's something slightly different to the usual music tech stuff that we feature on this channel. But if you have enjoyed it, please do make sure that you like the video, leave us a comment if you want, and do subscribe to our channel. Thanks very much, guys, and I'll see you again next time.